Hey guys, welcome to another tutorial. Some of you may have been onto the GitHub and you may have found a mod called the Hat Goose mod. For this mod, there are a couple things you could do with it. I mean, yes, the whole setup for the beginning is the same thing. So you just go and you put in your mods folder and there you go. Everything's all good. Make sure you've got it enabled in your config file, says enable mods true. The same stuff as I've said in the other videos. But for this mod, let's just run it real quick, show you what it does. You got your goose here, and you see he's got a little top hat. Now, what some people may not know is that you can actually change the hat. So, let me just stop this real quick. So, what you could do is you can go over to your hats mod, and after you run it once, you'll notice, if you go back to the mods folder, you'll notice that there is a new folder, new file that appears. It's called config. If you open this one up, you'll see all this. So, over here, we want custom hat. Instead of default, we'll say custom. Can't spell today. You'll see horizontal size. This is the size of the hat. You could just make this as big or as small as you want. Hat position, that changes the coordinates of the hat from the left or the right. It doesn't go up and down. If you want the hat to be higher or lower on the goose, you're going to need to modify the image itself, which I'm not going to get into that just yet. And then you got your custom hat path. For this part, what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to find a PNG. Alright, could be anything you want. For me, I have this folder right here, just called Hats. I forgot where I got it from, but the creator is 4NA, he's on Discord. You can find all these different little hats. I'll put this in the description if anybody wants it. All you need to do is just find your folder. You're going to go up here, you're going to select the file path and copy it. Go back over to your config, and you're going to paste it right into the custom hat path. At the end of it, though, you want to put the name of the hat that you want. So I'm going to let's use the Santa hat. So it's hat 3 PNG, so we'll just go back over to here. We'll add another slash, we'll say hat 3 PNG, and that's it. Let me just make sure, spelled it right, yes I did, okay, cool. The other thing you need to do is you also need to add an extra slash. Why is this the case? I really don't know. But you need to add an extra slash each time you do this. Alright, so once it looks like this, you should be all set to go. Just save it. And go back to your desktop use folder. Run it. And he's got a new hat. And that's all there is to it. Now, if you want to get really crazy with it, you can do all sorts of things. If you go into the assets folder and you adjust some sounds and you change the music and you change the bite sounds and the honk sounds and all that stuff, you can get pretty crazy like with this. For example, I've got this one right here. I'm not going to post this anywhere. If you guys want to make it, you're going to have to make it yourselves. But I made a Roomba mod for the goose. Now it's just a Roomba. Unfortunately, I can't get rid of the stepping sounds. That's somewhere hard-coded into the goose. I'll have to figure that out at some point. But for now, I mean, it works like a regular Roomba, but it still acts like the goose. So you can do all kinds of crazy things with this. Thanks for watching. If you guys are liking these videos, make sure you leave a like. And if you want to know anything specific on the goose, let me know about it in the comments. If you got questions about the goose, though, like how to get it working, support, stuff like that, be sure to check out the official Desktop Goose Discord, links in the description. It's a lot faster for me to answer questions there, and on top of that, you get to see all the other crazy projects that Sam Person, the creator of the Goose, has been working on. Thanks again for watching.